kitchen, and I gotta apologize. I wanted to do this one at the restaurant, but I needed my food processor, and I didn't bring it. So today, obviously, we went out and we netted a bunch of suckers. I cleaned them there. It was like a butchery on that truck. Thank goodness I did it out there, because if I actually cleaned those fish here, my wife would kill me. So today's recipe that I'm going to do, I am going to do my fish cakes. And fish cakes is such a great, it's a great recipe to do, especially when you have like fish with a lot of pin bones and it's such fish such as, I mean, fish for one, the suckers. Jackfish, like northerns, have a lot of pin bones in them. We're going to use it, we're going to grind them up. I'm going to show you a proper way of how I like to cut them up, and hopefully it works for you, and how I season them up, and do it from scratch all the way to the pot and pan and into my mouth, because I'm starved. It's been a long day, so let's get started. I'm going to show you what I have here. So as you can tell, this is my plate here. We got some cilantro, we got green onions, we got an egg, we got chopped up white onions. Then we got, these two are optional. The red chili flakes right over here, as well as the fresh Thai chili, because I like a little bit of spice in mine. I've also brought out, obviously, you got some of your seasoning salt, you got your salt, you got seasoning salt. This one over here, that is my chili garlic oil, which I make in-house here. It's mine. It's the one that I like to make. We got some soy sauce, a little blue jar here, some sugar, cayenne pepper, garlic salt, and obviously my food processor. And this is the meat right here itself. You obviously know that we cleaned it there, but I actually did a little bit more cleaning here at home before I got things all prepped up. Obviously I chopped up all the veggies and stuff. I did take away the bloodline. There was some bloodline in this fish. There's still some left, but it's very minimal. It's not bad, but as you can tell, you got some really, those three that I cut up that I was using for the fish cakes, this is how much meat I got out of it. It's the nice, nice, firm white meat. So what we're gonna do now is I'm gonna chop it up just to help break up the pin bones. Then we're gonna throw it in the food processor and then we'll go from there. I'm gonna take my nice little fillets and I'm going to cut them into little chunks. As you can tell, when you're cutting, you're feeling the pin bones and you're helping it. Even though I can cut it up in chunks, I just want to do it this way so I can get rid of those little pin bones and help it get grinded up a little more. You can feel it in the tail there. You'd think there wouldn't be any pin bones in that tail, but they're there. You can feel it as you go through there. That's why a lot of people like to pressure can these things. When they actually can these, the pressure cooking will actually help dissolve the pin bones. We're just going to take our fish, we're going to dump it in, put that aside, we're going to use that again. I typically like to use the pulse just so it actually chops it up. A couple of things that can go wrong if you just leave your food processor on and you just keep it going. What can end up happening is you're going to add a lot of air into your meat. It's going to overgrind it. It's going to put it all together and you're going to get this really spongy fish cake. So I still like to have it really chunky. I don't want it too overly fine, like too fine. However though, this being sucker fish with all the little pin bones, like if it was walleye, I would have been done after a couple pulses just to get it all nicely broken up, because I know there's no bones in my walleye fillets, but this, I know there's a lot of pin bones. So I'm gonna do it just a little bit more. And I think she is ready to rock. So, and then you're gonna just spoon it out. Oh my goodness, look at all this meat. Pretty stoked. Let's start back again with all our ingredients. We're gonna add a little bit of salt. Add some salt in there, don't have to add much. Hey, you know what? I brought the seasoning salt out too. Highs, why not? You got some seasoning, throw some in there too. I'm gonna put a little bit of garlic powder. Not too much, unless you really like garlic. I like garlic, adds great flavor. Some soy sauce, it wouldn't be Chinese fish cakes without a little bit of soya. Now, a key thing too, you should always add a little bit of sugar. little teaspoon of sugar in here. Gonna add my ingredients. I don't think I'm gonna need all this, so I'm gonna put some of the onions, the green onions, cilantro. Love the cilantro. We're gonna make it a little spicy here. Add the red chili flakes. We're gonna add the fresh Thai chilies. I love these things. Can't not have enough. Let's start stirring this in together first. See if I can get this all mixed up nice. Now, I did have this really cool thing here. This is my Screaming Sumo hot sauce. We serve it at the Palatal Stir Fry Express. It's actually one. It's a hot chili garlic water that I've made. I'm gonna add a scoop of this in there. It has a lot of flavor. You can actually buy similar stuff like this at some of the other the grocery stores. She is mixing nice. I am gonna add one egg in there though, just to help bind. This is perfect. Actually smells fantastic. Okay, so now that I've mixed in all my ingredients, and I'm gonna put a little list there of what I've used. I kind of just did this as the, you know, the typical dude, the guy thing. Pinch of salt, pinch of sugar. I didn't really measure much. I kind of know what I like in it. But next thing is what you're gonna need is you're gonna need some saran wrap. And this is actually a little key step. It's a little kind of a little secret little trick that we do. So I'm gonna put it down here. You can see I'm gonna take a nice portion of what I want. There you go. I'm gonna put it in there. And I'm gonna slightly kind of wrap it together like this. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna just kind of hit it while it kind of compresses everything together. You can shape it as well. There you go, that's one. I like to make mine into little squares. I actually ended up with five fish cakes. One is actually really big. Now, what's the best thing about this though? What's the best thing about that is whatever you don't use, you can freeze. I'm gonna put it on about medium heat, not high. I'm just gonna get it going right there. Just a little bit of canola oil. I'm gonna do my three small ones that I did up. See, they're all in one piece. There you go. Third one here. There you go. Just like that. Smells fantastic. Oh, look how golden brown that is. That is nice. That's exactly how we want it to turn out. Two to three minutes per side. When you're cooking it about, I think it's about a centimeter thick is what I have, Matt. I mean, it doesn't take long for it to cook through, as you know, it's fish, right? You just don't want to burn it, though. Like I said, so take your time. There's no problem with using a lower heat and making sure that you do it properly.
I'm so excited.
Now, this recipe itself, you can also use, like, walleye, northern. The next time you go up for suckers, you're probably going to think twice and probably want to try this. It is really good. This is my daughter Jocelyn. You're gonna see her this summer on the boat with me a lot. This girl loves to fish. Same with her bigger sister. Say hi, Joss.
Hi.
Can I go to bed?
Good night.
Good night. These things are done. So I'm just gonna turn it off. Pull them out the fire. Tell me that doesn't look yummy. Sucker fish cakes. Whatever you don't use, like I said, it's already wrapped in the saran wrap, the one that I used when I was throwing against the counter. It's ready. It's packaged exactly how I want it. I'm going to throw it to my freezer here. Save this for another day. My family ate all the rice. Come a little closer. Check this out. Oh, yeah. I'm going to take one of those. I'm going to put it right here. Take this other one. Oh, look at that. Save that one for later. Got my two little dipping sauces there. I have two fish cakes. I have a sweet Thai chili sauce. This is our volcano sauce, which is kind of like a chili ranch sauce that we serve at the restaurant. Goes great with all this. You can add a little soy sauce to it, but this is all you really need. So let's head over to the table and let's eat some food. Let's try it out. Let's look at this. So if you come on in, come check this out. You can look at this flakiness. It looks so good. You can see all the cilantro, the green onions. Let's do one taste here without no sauce. Oh wow, that is phenomenal. All I have to say is this thing is amazing. Early season spring sucker fish cakes. It doesn't get any better than that. There are absolutely no bones. The flavor is unbelievable. Like I said, I enjoy spiciness. That's an option for you. You don't have to add the chilies or even the chili garlic oil. I mean, if you just use the regular seasonings and you do it up this way, you will not be disappointed. So I hope you enjoy this recipe. I hope you go out and try it. Go out there, get some suckers, put the recipe to test. Let me know what you think about it. Give us a like on Facebook and on YouTube at Big China Outdoors. Don't forget to subscribe. Other than that, I'm going back to eating because it's been a long day and I'm starved and I am out of here. Peace.